सुरू करता है सर, आता स्टार्ट करो सर।
स्टार्ट करो ना। ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी। टुडेस टॉपिक इज ऑर्गेनिक इरिटेट्स, दैट इज एनिमल इन दिस स्नेक। विल डील विथ स्नेक एनिमेशन। नो, द स्टडी ऑफ स्नेक इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ओफियोलॉजी। नो, स्नेक्स आर सिलिंड्रिकल लॉन्ग लिम्बलेस क्लोल ब्लडेड रेप्टाइल्स। द बॉडी ऑफ स्नेक इज डिवाइडेड इंटू द हेड, ट्रंक एंड टेल। सो वी हैव फाइव फैमिलीज ऑफ पॉइजनस स्नेक्स। क्लोबराइडी, दैट इज एग्जाम्पल, अफ्रीकन ब्लूम स्नेक्स, then Arachnospidae, that is mole vipers or adders, then Elapidae, then we have viper, and we have Hydrophidae. Hydrophidae means water, means these are the sea snakes. So in this entire topic, these two snakes, Elapidae and viper, these are important from treatment point of view. So common poison snakes found in India are cobra, देवी बी कॉमन कोबरा और किंग कोबरा। देन वी हैव क्रेट्स, कॉमन क्रेट एंड बैंडेड क्रेट। देन वाइपर्स, वी हैव रसल्स वाइपर एंड सॉस्कल्ड वाइपर। एंड अमॉन्ग सी स्नेक्स, वी हैव बैंडेड सी स्नेक और एफिबियन सी स्नेक्स। सो अबाउट 20 सी स्नेक्स आर पॉइजनस विच आर फाउंड इन द सी ऑफ इंडियन सी, वेयरएज 42 स्नेक्स ऑन लैंड आर पॉइजनस। So these are some examples of common non-poisonous snakes which may resemble like that of poisonous snakes. So among commonest is the dhaman, that is a rat snake. Then we have vine snake, we have bronze back tree snake, then banded kukri or sand boa. So these are some non-poisonous snakes which resembles that of poisonous snakes. Now how to differentiate between a poisonous snake and a non-poisonous snake? Usually the poisonous snakes are dull in color, they are stout, whereas in case of non-poisonous snakes they are bright and slender. Now one of the important feature to differentiate poisonous non-poisonous snake is the tail. So in case of non-poisonous, it is a dagger tail. In case of poisonous, it ends abruptly. So whereas in case of non-poisonous, it's a gradual tapering. Then belly scales, in case of non-poisonous, they are never complete, whereas in case of poisonous snakes, they are complete. In case of non-poisonous, they are never complete, means the belly scales are divided. In case of teeth, at least one pair of teeth are modified in upper jaw to form of fangs, whereas in case of non-poisonous, all teeth are small and of a uniform size. So this is the belly scales, this is the poisonous snakes, and upper photo shows belly scale of non-poisonous snake. First is common cobra. The zoological name is Naja Naja. The common names are common cobra or Nag. They are usually brown or black in color. The head is covered with shield. And cobras have a hood. This is a hood. Pupils are round. So you can see the hood of cobra. So dorsal aspect of hood may have monocelate mark or a binocelate mark. This is a binocelate mark and this is a monocelate mark. So usually monocelate cobras are usually found in West Bengals. Ventral surface of the hood have two dark spots. Fangs are short, grooved and situated anteriorly. Tail is cylindrical and the venom is neurotoxic. So we have crate and cobra where the neurotoxic is, the venom is neurotoxic. Now this is a king cobra. This is one of the largest poisonous snakes found in worldwide. Now this snake is usually present in Western Ghats, usually in the Goa, Karnataka or Tamil Nadu. Next is the common crate. The zoological name is Bungarus cerulus. The common names are Indian crate or Maniyar or Kavadia. Usually it is a steel blue or black in color, and there will be white bands on the back of a snake. Pupils are round. Large hexagonal scales were present. So these are the hexagonal scales which are present over the back of a snake. Fangs are short, grooved and situated anteriorly. So in case of cobra and crate, the fangs are short, whereas in case of viper, the fangs are long. Whereas in case of cobra and crate, the fangs are grooved. In case of viper, it is channelized. So I will show a photograph. Again, the venom is neurotoxic. Now, this sort of fangs are present in cobra and crate, whereas figure A shows the fangs which are present in viper. They are channelized, whereas in case of cobra or crate, they are grooved. Banded crate, the zoological name is Bungarus fasciculatus. Common name is banded crate. So you can see the beautiful yellow and black alternate black band over this particular snake. On cross section, the bands are triangular in shape. I will show the photograph. As per habitat, the snake is shy in nature, usually seen often basking near the water bodies in morning hours. The venom is neurotoxic. Now you can see the triangular shape of this snake, and you can see the alternate band, yellow and black. Saw-scaled viper, the zoological name is Icarus carpus. The common name is carpet viper, usually also called as Fursa or Afai. Now this is one of the most aggressive snake. The maximum length is about 2 feet. Since it usually lives in dark places like beneath the carpet or beneath the sofa set or behind the cupboards. So that's why it is also called as carpet viper. Very aggressive snake, viviparous. So you can remember V for viper, V for viviparous snake, V for vertical pupil, and V for venom, the vascular toxic venom, V. So you can remember like this, V for viviparous, V for viper, V for vascular toxic snake venom. So you can see the white line over the trunk of this snake. Pupils are vertical, right? In case of crate or cobra, we have seen the pupils are circular, whereas these pupils are vertical. Wavy white line, zigzag pattern, may present on each. Diamond markings over back. Now the scales of viper are serrated, saw-like. Thus, it bears the name saw-scaled viper. When the snake gets aggressive, it rubs over the surface, and we can hear the sound like rubbing the sandpaper. That's why it's called as saw-scaled viper. It's a very aggressive snake. Fangs are long, curved, hollow, channelized, and they are hinged. Whereas in case of cobra or crate, they are grooved. Venom is vascular-toxic. Whereas in case of cobra and crate, the venom is neurotoxic. So Russell's viper, this is a stout snake. The zoological name is Vipera russelli. The common name is Kandahar or Ghunus. It is a stout snake, usually brownish in color. Pupils are vertical. It has a long nostrils. When get irritated, the snake makes a very large hissing sound. So you can appreciate on this photograph the Russell's viper. You can appreciate these are three chain-like structures, designs, and you could appreciate semi-elliptical scales of the snake, and these are the chain-like design present over the body of snake. The scales are semi-elliptical. Right now I have shown you three rows of chain dark spots present on the back. Fangs are long, curved, hollow and channelized. when disturbed or when the snake gets irritated, it makes loud hissing sound. Venom is vascular toxic. They are bluish or greyish or greenish in color, usually in water, shallow water usually. They will live for half an hour. Again, they will come on the surface of our water to inhale or to breathe. The tail is flat and paddle shaped. So this is the tail basically. Now the paddle shaped tail will help the snake to swim in a water. Now they will not crawl on a ground or on earth. The venom is myotoxic. So we have three sort of venom. One is myotoxic sea snake. We have neurotoxic cobra and we have vipers. Now venom is a toxic saliva. It is secreted from modified parotid salivary gland. On gross examination, it is a clear amber colored liquid when it is a fresh. It contains numerous proteins, low molecular weight polypeptides, glycoproteins, and numerous enzymes like proteinase, ATPase, like that. Basically, it is a cocktail of numerous molecules. So you can appreciate the amber color venom. So venom may be a neurotoxic, for example, cobra and crate, vascular toxic and hemotoxic, that is a viper, and a biotoxic, that is a sea snake. So what are the clinical features when a person is bitten by a non-poisonous snakes? So usually there is a fear and apprehension. Obviously, one get feared when there is a snake. Even we wave a snake, we get sweating. The patient may be in a state of shock. There may be a feeble pulse. The patient may be in a hypotension or a syncope, or there may be increased thing. Or there will be palpitations. Bacteria show multiple teeth marks, whereas in case of poisonous snake bite, there are two fangs marks are identified. So now clinical features in case of elapid, that is viper, cobra and crate. They are different because the poison is neurotoxic, whereas clinical features of viper are different since the poison is vascular toxic and hemotoxic. So first we will see clinical features of elapid, that is cobra and crate. Local features, we will see the fan marks. Whenever there is a injury, body will try to react in form of inflammation. So the fangs marks will be surrounded by signs of inflammation. There will be burning pain at the site of bitten area. So in case of cobra, that burning pain can be identified very easily. However, in case of crate, the burning pain is much less, or the patient may not feel pain at any way. So that's why the casualties in night hours in case of crate are more, because the pain is not very appreciable. There will be swelling and discoloration because of extravasation of blood, and sometimes few blisters may be there. So serosanguinous discharge may be present from the bite site. It is a discharge which will mixed with blood and a fluid. So it is a serosanguinous blood. It is not a frank hemorrhage. It is a serosanguinous discharge. In comparison with viper bite, local manifestations are milder in case of cobra or crate. Since the vipers are vascular toxic, more manifestations local will be there in form of hemorrhage. So you could appreciate some blisters with discoloration of foot. So we have two things. One is pre-paralytic stage and second is paralytic stage. Since it is a neurotoxic, it will affect our brain. So the pre-paralytic stage is characterized by vomiting, headache, giddiness, weakness, and lethargy. So the paralytic stage is characterized by paralytic feature with ptosis. There is a dropping of eyelid. Then there may be achondroplasia, drowsiness, dysarthria. Again, is one of the earlier manifestation of cobra or crate envenomation. So the person is not able to speak properly. Now there may be a convulsions, terminal convulsions because of hypoxia of brain. Eventually, if the paralysis spreads, it causes verbal paralysis, respiratory failure, and eventually a patient may die. So this schematic diagram shows, or this flowchart shows, a pre-paralytic stage, then patient lands in paralytic stage, then there is a verbal paralysis, respiratory failure, and eventually patient dies. So in case of VIPER, local features, it is a rapid filling of a bilated area. Since it is a gastrotoxic, it will derange the coagulation cascade. This is the coagulation mechanism of blood will be deranged, and blood will be more, there will be more hemorrhage. So there is a more discoloration because of hemorrhage in the surrounding area. Multiple blisters will be formed at a local site. Sometimes if the snake has bitten at a toe, sometimes the blister even extend up to trunk. Then bleeding from bite site, where in the case of cobra or crate, we have seen discharge of serosynchronous fluid, whereas in case of VIPER, we have bleeding from the bite site. Again, it is characterized by pain. So you could appreciate, if you compare previous picture with this picture, you could appreciate the tremendous amount of blister formation, then discoloration, multiple blister formations. Since it deranged coagulation cascade, so it is characterized by epitaxis, that is bleeding from mouth, nostrils, then there may be hemoptysis, there may be hematemesis, there may be bleeding from gum, hematuria or melena. The hemorrhagic areas or skin may be found, under the mucosa. Since there is a loss of blood, a patient may land in shock. Because of shock, there is a renal failure. So coming to sea snake, that is hydrophyte, since it is a myotoxic, manifestations will be more related with muscles. So the bitten area shows swelling. Since it is a myotoxic, it will cause myalgia, then there will be muscle stiffness, myoglobinuria, and eventually there will be a renal failure. So how to diagnose a case? Now, there are three cardinal features based on which we can diagnose a patient. So we have to first identify the fan marks, then identify the snakes. If sometimes reduce, bring the snake in emergency department or in casualty, so you can view the snake and then identify, and we have laboratory methods. So in case poisonous snakes, two fangs marks are identified over a skin, whereas in case of non-poisonous, multiple bite marks may be identified. So here you could appreciate, these are the fangs, so you can appreciate two fang marks over a bitten area, whereas in case multiple teeth marks are there. So there may be a leukocytosis with thrombocytopenia on blood examination. There may be hemolysis or fragmented RBCs. Now this picture more resembles with VIPER bite. Increase prothrombin time and increase PTT. Now there are certain tests, immunodiagnostic tests, which can diagnose the snake bite, like immunodiffusion, countercurrent immunoelectrophoresis, ELISA, or radioimmunoassay. So management. So in case of non-poisonous snake bite, allaying the fear of a person or allaying the anxiety of a person is very much important because sometimes the patient may be in a state of shock. Reassure the patient that each and every snake is not a poisonous snake. So reassure the patient, then poisonous snake bite. Now we will divide this management in two part, that is on-field management and in-hospital management. So first aid and field management. Reassure the patient, limit the systemic spread of venom by immobilizing the affected part. For example, if it is bitten over a toe, immobilize that toe. If you don't immobilize, or if you run or if you walk, there is a chance that venom may spread in the body rapidly. So just immobilize the affected limb. So you can use the splint. Splint is nothing but you can splint maybe a stick or maybe a hard cardboard, so you can apply that particular stick or cardboard to that affected limb and tie with some rope. In case of viper, the bitten limb should be splinted and get across approximately heart level. Now, do's and don'ts, especially while giving first aid. Now, reassure the patient, remove the patient from the vicinity where the snake had bitten, because there is a tendency among snakes after biting a victim, snake usually lurk in that area for a few minutes. So as soon as possible, leave the place where a snake has bitten, immobilize the bitten limb, if possible apply splint, then arrange some vehicle to ship the patient to nearest hospital. Now, what are don'ts? It is advised that victim should not run or walk because this will cause rapid spread of venom. Do not make any incision at a local site. Do not use any sort of tourniquet. Don't drink coffee or don't drink any sort of alcohol. Don't try to catch the snake, because sometimes while catching a snake, mortalities are recorded. So click picture away from the snake with the help of mobile phone. Now this picture will help the treating doctor to identify a snake correctly. So don't try to catch snake physically. So for elapid or snake bite, it is called as Australian pressure immobilization technique is a beneficial. Now in this particular technique, what is done? A crab bandage usually is wrapped around the bitten limb. So these are do's and don'ts. This is wash the area with copious amount of clean water, splint the area, and ship the patient to nearest hospital. Hospital management. So first and foremost, monitor the vitals, stabilize the patient, monitor the vitals, have oxygen, watch for the urine output, especially in case of viper, because the patient may land in shock and there may be reduced renal function. Because of that, there may be reduced output. Now the level of local edema or swelling or erythema in the affected limb should be marked with ballpoint pen, and the circumference should be measured every 15 minutes until the swelling is stabilized. Now if you feel that the swelling is increasing, you have to start antivenom treatment. It is an indication that you have to start the antivenom treatment. You have an intravenous access. The patient should be given IV fluids. If the patient is in state of shock, vasopressors like dopamine or dobutamine, blood and urine should be collected for laboratory examination. Then apply dry sterile dressing to the bitten part. A splint may be affected. The tetanus immunization should be updated, because the mouth of that snake may contain very anaerobic and aerobic bacteria. If there is a swelling continuing affected limb and there is impending danger of compartment syndrome, so you should consider antivenom therapy. This is a snake bite treatment. Now, it is administered only when indicated. So the antivenom are available as a two forms. One is monovalent, that is specific, and polyvalent. In India, we have polyvalent antivenom that is effective against common cobra, common crate, Russell's viper, and soft-coiled viper. Now the antivenom should be administered with a caution, because it is of horse origin or equine origin and it carries the risk of anaphylaxis. So prior to administration of antivenom infusion, the patient should refuse appropriate loading doses of antihistamine. The antivenom should be administered as an intravenous infusion. It should be mixed or dissolved in 500 ml of normal saline or Ringer's lactate or 5% dextrose for adults, whereas in case of children, it should be infused at 20 milliliter per kg of her. These are photographs of antivenom that is a polyvalent. Sometimes in case of viper snake bite, there may be hemorrhage or a bleeding may be there and it requires fresh transfusion of blood or fresh frozen plasma. In case of crate or cobra, since it is a neurotoxic poison, there may be features of neurotoxicity. Now in this case, you have to consider administration of neostigmine. Now remember, every neostigmine should be preceded with a dose of atropine. So you have to give neostigmine plus atropine in case of neurotoxic poison. Then administer oxygen, if required, have a ventilatory support. Now these are the indications of antivenom therapy. If there is a deranged coagulation profile in case of viper snake bite, if there is a spontaneous bleeding, rapidly progressive local swelling, persistent hypertension in spite of giving vasopressors like dopamine or dobutamine, neurotoxic manifestations or myotoxic manifestations, if there is a depressed consciousness, or if there is a deranged laboratory values like deranged coagulation profile or increased thromboplastin time. So these are adverse reactions to antivenom. One is immediate anaphylaxis and second is delayed complication. That is delayed type of hypersensitivity reactions. So these two things should be anticipated while giving antivenom. Coming to postmortem examination findings. So on examination of body, we can find fang marks. There may be local swelling, there may be signs of inflammation, there may be discoloration because of extravasation of blood, there may be blister formation. There may be bleeding diastasis, especially in case of viper. We can find hemorrhage in mucosa and visceral areas. Then there may be froth at mouth and nostrils because of pulmonary edema. The organs are usually congested. So coming to particular importance, most of the deaths are accidental nature. In India, one case report is reported regarding homicidal nature of snake fatality. One person was killed with the help of professional snake catcher. So usually the deaths are accidental nature. Sometimes because of biting of snake, there will be permanent functional loss of any member or that particular bitten area. And all species of snakes, crocodiles, turtles, and some species of lizards are protected under the Indian Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So preventive measures. Learn to recognize venomous snake. Keep your premises always clean. Do not walk about in the dark. Always carry a torch. Do not walk along the border of water bodies or lake, especially in case of winter season. Try to walk in the middle of road because for obtaining warmth, since the snakes are cold-blooded animal, they will need warmth. To have a warmth, many times especially it comes along the border of road. Snake and it will escape. Learn to recognize the signals that a snake may give as a warning. For example, if in case of cobra, if it expands its hood, so feel threatened that snake is now in a position to bite. Or if vipers are there, if they are making hissing noise, so try to learn or recognize the signals a snake is given. If you spot a snake and you feel that a snake, take the help of professional people or professional snake catcher. Now, some interesting facts about snakes. Dr. Patrick Russell is considered as father of ophiology. Ophiology is the study of snakes. There are about 2,700 species of snakes in the world, and among them 275 are found in India. Among them 42 are found on land and 20 are found in sea. The largest poisonous snakes in India and probably about in the world is king cobra and maximum length of that snake is about 15.5 feet. Oh, snake do not have ears. The forked tongue of a snake is primarily an organ of smell. It transfers scent particles from the environment to the Jacobson's organ and then distinguish. Snake cannot chew food. The teeth which are present in the oral cavity of a snake is to hold a prey. So snake never chew a food. They swallow food whole. They are exclusively carnivorous. Snake sheds their skin periodically. Now sometimes there is a dry bite. So the percentage of dry bite varies from 20 to 80%. So what is dry bite? Means even though the snake has bitten a victim, but do not inject venom. So it is called as dry bite. For newborn snake is more dangerous than the adult one because the fangs are functional in case of newborn and they are independent from their parents. So additional information if you need for snakes regarding any other things or you need literature, we have Chennai Snake Park at Chennai. Then at Pune, we have Nilam Kumar Khairej, founder and director of Kathraj Snake Park. Then we have a good website, Snake Bite Healing and Education Society. Then another website is that www.indiansnakes.org. Ashokan is one of the person who is considered as an authority on Indian snakes. So this is all about snakes and the bites, the venoms, and the management of snake envenomation. So thank you very much. Hello.
हाँ सर, संपला का लेक्चर
हो लेक्चर संपला हो
थैंक यू सर थैंक यू